Welcome to the Fit Small Business QuickBooks Online training course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to manually enter business credit card transactions in QuickBooks Online. To follow along with me, log into your QuickBooks Online account now or click the link below for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. You can also click this link to access our full QuickBooks Online course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. In our lesson on how to import your credit card transactions into QuickBooks, we talked about the most efficient way of doing this by using one of two methods. First, automatically connect your credit card account to QuickBooks, or import your credit card transactions from an Excel CSV file. If you are unable to do this because your credit card company does not offer either of these options, you will need to manually enter your credit card transactions into QuickBooks. We will cover how to do this in this lesson. Before you can manually enter your credit card transactions into QuickBooks, you need to set up the credit card. To start, we want to navigate to the chart of accounts list, so go ahead and click on the gear icon located to the left of your company name. Below the Your Company column, select Chart of Accounts. The chart of accounts will display. We want to go ahead and click the blue New button in the upper right-hand corner. And we will go ahead and complete these fields for our fictitious company, Paul's Plumbing. The first field is category type. From the drop-down, we want to select the type of account that we are downloading transactions for. In this example, that's going to be credit card. Detail type. This field automatically populates based on the selection that we made in the category type field. So if I go back to category type and I select bank, notice that the detail type options change. The name field. This is how the account will show up in QuickBooks. So we want to go ahead and put the credit card name, and you want to go ahead and add the last four digits of the account number in this field. This is also going to be the same information that we're going to put in the description field. If you've got more than one business credit card that you plan to connect to QuickBooks, including the name of the card and the last four digits of the card number allow you to easily tell one credit card account from another when you are entering transactions and reconciling these accounts. The credit card balance. In order for you to successfully reconcile your credit card accounts, you need to indicate the ending balance on your credit card statement in this field. The credit card statement that you use will be determined by the date that you start using QuickBooks. For example, if you start using QuickBooks as of January 1st, then you want to use the ending balance on your December credit card statements. So the as of date here, we're going to go ahead and put an ending date of December 31st, 2015. Double check to make sure that you have made all the correct selections in all the fields and then click Save and Close. The new credit card account will appear on the chart of accounts list. We'll scroll down and find that. There we go. This is a credit card that we just set up. From this account list, we want to go ahead and click on the View Register link to the far right. And we'll go in and talk about how to add a new transaction to the credit card register. Here's the credit card register. So the first field is the drop-down that will allow us to select which credit card we want to enter transactions for. You can easily switch between credit card registers by clicking this link, this drop-down, and selecting the credit card from the drop-down. The ending balance is the current balance of the credit card account. When you enter credit card transactions in QuickBooks, the credit card balance is immediately updated. The reconcile button to the right of the balance is the button you want to use to activate the reconcile tool. So we won't do that right now, but in the reconciling credit card accounts lesson, we walk through step by step how to reconcile credit card accounts. Click this link to view this lesson. The date field will be the transaction date of the credit card charge or credit. The reference number and type field. If you have a reference number that will help you to identify this transaction in the future, you can enter that number in this field. You can also enter text in this field. The transaction type will appear directly below that, credit card expense or credit card credit, for example, and we will walk through how to select the transaction type in a few minutes. Payee and account. For charges, this field will include the payee and the expense account the purchase was categorized to. For credits or payments, this field will include the vendor the credit was received from, along with the expense account it was categorized to. In the memo field, you would typically include some additional information about the transaction. For example, the charge was to buy plumbing supplies. Charge. You want to enter the amount charged to your credit card in this field. Payment. Enter the payment or credits that appear on your credit card statement. So this will be any payments that you made throughout the month or any credits applied to your account you want to enter in this field. So now that we have discussed each of these fields, let's go ahead and enter a credit card transaction for our fictitious company, Paul's Plumbing. So to do that, the first thing we want to do is select the transaction type. So from the dropdown, as you can see, we have several options to choose from. We've got credit card expense, credit card credit, bill payment, transfer, and journal entry. So we'll go ahead and enter a credit card expense, and then we'll tab over to the reference number field. In this field, again, you can indicate something that will help you remember what this charge is for. It is optional, so we'll go ahead and tab over to our payee and account and select our payee. Notice when we select the payee, the memo field and the charge amount were automatically populated. That is because that's the charge that we entered last for this particular payee. So we did purchase garbage disposals, but we'll go ahead and change the dollar amount for the new purchase. And then from the drop down here, you want to select the account that this expense needs to be categorized to. So we will leave it as job materials for this particular expense. And once you are comfortable that all of the information is correct, you can go ahead and click the Save button. If you need to make changes to a transaction that was previously entered into the credit card register, you can easily do that. From this screen, you would just simply click on the transaction that you want to make changes to. So we'll go ahead and click on that transaction that we just entered. And notice that the fields are all available for us to make edits to. So we can make changes to any of these fields and then make sure that we save our changes here. Now that wraps up the lesson on how to manually enter business credit card transactions into QuickBooks Online. To access our full QuickBooks Online course or any of the other lessons in this series, click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. If you have feedback about this course or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.